Welcome all to the Class of 2022 graduation ceremony. My name is Rebecca Balinescu, this is Anvu and Rahim Hadi, and we were this year's head students. We have been honored to serve such an important role in student activities and had the pleasure to be the representatives of the whole student body this academic year. We hope we had had a lasting impact during our time here, as we will also be today's MCs. We are very grateful that you could join us as we proudly mark one of the biggest milestones in our lives as of yet, if not the biggest. This event will bring both joy and melancholy as we mark both the end of a 13-year-old journey as well as new beginnings and new opportunities for us all.
The Class of 2022 is delighted to welcome you all to this tremendous occasion. We hope this day will be an unforgettable memory as we reflect on the past few years of our lives and celebrate our accomplishments.
In the true spirit of internationalism, we will now have the graduates introduce the ACG School Jakarta Class of 2022 graduation ceremony in various languages from around the world.
Bună ziua tuturor! Mulțumesc că ați venit la ceremonia noastră de absolvire. Sper să vă simțiți bine.
Kính thưa các thầy cô giáo, các bạn học sinh thân mến, cảm ơn quý vị có mặt ngày hôm nay và hy vọng chúng ta sẽ có một buổi lễ tốt nghiệp vui vẻ.
Meri taraf se aap sabko assalamu alaikum. Aapka aaj ki graduation ceremony mein aane ka bahut shukriya. Mujhe ummeed hai ki aapko aaj ki graduation taqreeb bahut pasand aayegi.
Thank you, everyone. Now I would like to introduce Mr. Todd, our DP coordinator and vice principal, who has witnessed our stress, our difficulties, our anxieties, our suffering, our pain, all our late submissions, late night emails begging him for yet another extension, all the effects of the tremendous pressure and tension I be welcomed us with. As finally, today, he will guide us to the moment when all our struggles have paid off, as we depart and transition to the next great chapter of our lives.
Mr. Todd has guided us towards the future we want to make for ourselves. We appreciate his patience with us as we have navigated through the university applications process. I personally would love to thank him for always being available to answer any inquiries I asked of him. We are sure he's the proudest one of all to see us march confidently towards our future. I would now like to invite Mr. Todd on the stage to say a few words.
Thank you, students. Dear parents, colleagues, and graduates, it is a great pleasure to address you on what is your final official day at ACG School Jakarta. Sorry, I didn't expect to get emotional about this, but I've seen this happen three times with my own children. Wow. I really wasn't expecting this. I'm normally a very cool, calm and collected Englishman, but it's actually quite emotional. I've done this three times with my own children. I know what this means to you, so please forgive me. It's been a very difficult 2 years for most people around the world, but no other cohort in my teaching experience has had to show so much perseverance, blind optimism, and psychological fortitude as yourselves. You've learned to find solutions to problems no other group has experienced, and are now more resourceful than any other group. I know that you will draw upon these experiences of the last 2 years as you step onto the threshold of life beyond school. Now, it is traditional for older people like myself to give younger people like yourselves advice on occasions such as this. And to be honest with you, I'm not sure you will want to hear what I've got to say. It might well be boring, probably very similar to what you might hear from other people of my generation. I did try and make this interesting, novel, and funny, and it just looked silly on the page, and it sounded even sillier coming out of my mouth. So here it is, boring or not. Be honest with yourselves, first, last, and always. Only then can you be honest with others. Know who loves you, who cares for you. Act in kind. Learn something new, useful, practical, and real as often as you can. If you trust and value things, ideas, and people, make sure that they deserve it. And in these curious times, I would add one more thing. Be open to almost everything that life has to offer. So that means be brave, but not crazy. Graduates, have a fantastic day. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Todd. I would also like to express my gratitude to Mr. Todd for the help that he's offered us in submitting our university applications, as well as his support in the IB Diploma program. As this was his last year at ACG School Jakarta, we thank him for his services to making the school better, and we wish him the very best in the future. Now, Anwu will take it from here and deliver a dance performance called Permission to Dance by BTS. Please welcome An.
The thought of being young, when your heart's just like a drum, beating louder with no way to guard it. When it all seems like it's wrong, sing along to Elton John, until that feeling we're just getting started. When the nights get colder, and the rhythm's got you falling behind, dream about that moment, when you look yourself right in the eye. Then you say, I wanna dance, the music's got me going. Nothing that can stop how we move. Yeah, let's break our plans and live just like we're golden. Rolling like we're dancing fools. We don't need to worry, cause when we fall we know how to land. Don't need to talk the talk, just walk the walk tonight. There's always something that's standing in the way, but if you don't let it faze ya, you know just how to break, just keep the right vibe, yeah. Cause there's no looking back, there ain't no one to prove we don't got this unlocked, yeah. The wait is over, the time is now, so let's do it right. Yeah, we'll keep going and stay up until we see the sunrise. Then we'll say, I wanna dance, the music's got me going. Nothing that can stop how we move. Yeah, let's break our plans and live just like we're golden. Rolling like we're dancing fools. We don't need to worry, cause when we fall we know how to land. Don't need to talk the talk, just walk the walk tonight. Cause we don't need permission to dance. No, we don't need permission to dance. Well, let me show you that we could keep the fire alive. Cause it's not over till it's over. Sing it one more time. Say! just like we're golden, rolling like we're dancing, like we're dancing fools. We know how to land, 'cause we don't need permission to dance. No, we don't need permission to dance. No, we don't need permission to dance. No, we don't need permission to dance. Hey! 'Cause we don't need permission to dance.
Wow, Anne, that was an incredible performance. I think now we are all in the mood to dance. Now I'd love to introduce the teacher speakers. The first time I met Mr. McTiernan was during MUN Singapore alongside Anne and Rahim. The situation was far from ideal as the conference happened online, but I vividly remember the incredible support Mr. McTiernan provided to me throughout. Whenever I was unsure of my opening statement, the resolution, or the amendment speech, he always gave us unconditional feedback and support at all times of day. I think we can all agree how incredibly dedicated Mr. McTiernan is to the ACG community, as he keeps giving daily. I learned so much from him, and I'm so glad that he joined us today.
Mr. McTiernan is a teacher whom I have much respect for. He is very kind and always makes time to help his students, even outside of school hours. His detailed way of teaching is very beneficial, and I found quite a lot of success in my studies when following his advice. Although I have never had a subject with him, I am grateful to have been his student in MUN and advisory. Mr. McTiernan motivates me to work harder after seeing all the effort he puts into his work.
For me, Mr. McTiernan is a very approachable and calm teacher who's always helped me in various aspects of high school. From being my advisor in years 11 and 12 to teaching us global perspectives in ITGS, he's always been dedicated in ensuring that we received the help that we needed. His dedication to supporting students outside school hours was not only there for our academics, but also in helping us in our debating in Taiwan 2020 Singapore. Alongside my interest in technical subjects, Mr. McTiernan has created a solid complement by teaching us humanities with enthusiasm for many years. So now I would like to invite him to say a few words.
Good morning, everyone. So I'm just going to start by giving a greeting in Irish. Gioguich Cachtina agus Cade Mila Falsherod. Good morning, Principal, Vice Principal, colleagues, families and friends, students and outgoing class of 2022. I am honoured and pleased to be asked to deliver this farewell speech, as today is a day of joy and accomplishment for the class of 2022. We are all here to bid farewell to a special group of young adults who have encountered challenges like no other group of graduating students in completing this part of their journey to future happiness and success. Over the last 2 years, you have learned to be resilient and strong, determined and self-motivated, and to be interactive, engaging, so that you could meet your academic goals and overcome the challenge of not being in the company of classmates and your teachers every day. You've strived to be a success from first thing in the morning to last thing at night. You have completed your learning both in isolation and with your peers and teachers online, or even in the classroom. You have maintained friendships through all digital means available, and at the same time, you probably got to know your parents a lot better than you ever did before. In overcoming the challenges of the last 2 years, you've learned to foster positive and enduring relationships at a much younger age than your teachers, and this will help you in all areas of your life in the years to come. Never forget what your parents have done for you. Without your parents, you would not have received the opportunity to receive an international education and thus the means to follow your dreams. Without your parents, you would have not received the support, care, and encouragement needed to succeed in the midst of a global pandemic. And without your parents, you would not have developed those characteristics of determination, perseverance, self-motivation, resilience, and most importantly of all, care and empathy for others. Characteristics which will ensure your success and happiness in the years to come. I first made my acquaintance with the graduating class of 2022 when they were starting their high school journey in year 10. It was immediately apparent that here was a group who were ready to share their ideas, embrace new concepts, and take risks. They were talented in music class. We had performers in many different styles and on many different instruments. And they were able to apply these talents to outstanding performances in class concerts. They were keen and enthusiastic in global perspectives class, and recognizing that they could develop their critical thinking and communication skills and apply these to many other subjects. They applied themselves with a keen desire to succeed. Over the next 4 years, we had many academic successes and a few challenges also. Preparing coursework for CIE and IB submission, preparing for written examinations, and most difficult of all, learning to learn effectively in a virtually online learning scenario. All challenges were met with a desire to succeed and a willingness to find new ways to overcome the difficulties they faced. They also knew how to organize and participate in school events, such as Halloween night, International Day, Christmas concert, and they were superb on camp. Activities included hiking at night, zip lining, archery, learning to dance in Jai Pong style, making puppets using coconut leaves, campfire sing-along, and all were carried off with both a sense of fun and a brave eagerness to take risks and challenge themselves. Today, I'm honored to say that we are proud of your many achievements over the years, your various accomplishments in almost all curriculum and extracurricular activities. Your achievements in academic pursuits and in sports are indeed acknowledged, and we as your teachers would like to thank you for the happy memories that you have given us. Most of all, we wish to thank you for the commitment you have demonstrated towards your studies, in your relationship with the teachers, management, students in other year levels, and even among yourself over one of the most challenging periods in education. We wish you well in the pursuit of your dreams and ambitions wherever the next part of your journey may take you, and please, 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 never forget your time at ACG School Jakarta. You will always be welcome. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. McTiernan. Moving on, we will now share our experiences with IB Math. For me, math was an immense challenge. It was definitely the subject I had stayed up nights to study for. I know for sure I would have gotten nowhere if it were not for Ms. Pickering. She always helped me the best she could, while also pushing me to achieve more than I ever thought I could. Even outside of a classroom, she makes sure to check up on me when she senses something is off. I could not be more thankful to have a teacher like Ms. Pickering, and I will very dearly miss her when I go off to university. So Ms. Pickering, even though you're not here with us today, I would like to say thank you for all these years, and I hope you stay healthy and happy in the years to come.
Contrary to popular opinion, math was not as a daunting experience as others like to share. For me, the most influential part of math was helping out my fellow students to understand the concepts that we learned over the past 2 years, whether that was from simple trigonometry or all the way up to integral calculus. Often we would get stuck on complex problems, however, we were able to collaborate with each other and Ms. Pickering to enhance our understanding of interconnected mathematical concepts. Having been a student of Ms. Pickering for 3 years, I can safely say that she prepared me well for IB Math along with IGCSE, and she's really enabled me to apply math to the real world through the internal assessment. As this was her last year at ACG School Jakarta, we also express our gratitude towards her, and we wish her the very best in the future.
To be honest, I have always struggled with mathematics, different from Rahim. It has always seemed like a very rigorous and difficult subject for me. However, now I can confidently say that with the support of Ms. Hiskin and her contagious smile and jokes, it has become one of my favorite subjects. At first, our class overcame some difficulties, as it is always difficult to adapt to new teaching methods. However, together we learned to pursue math in creative ways, which taught me to truly value and appreciate it. I specifically remember the struggle of my internal assessment. I kept getting negative areas for my integration, which made me question my whole existence. However, Ms. Hiskin is someone who you can come to after school anytime and ask for help, which she will always offer gladly. She inspired all of us to try our best and pursue math for our own enjoyment, besides just the IB curriculum. I think we can all say that we will miss her very much as she became our friend. So let's all welcome Ms. Hiskin.
All right, let's give this a try, see if you still remember. When I say differential calculus, you say? No. No. Well, when I asked this question in class, I was on the edge of my seat hoping that someone would say gradient. You can imagine that it was very funny that after a moment of silence, all I heard was hard, similar to no. It was one of the funniest moments in class. Yes, most students would agree that differential calculus is hard. But we also had a lot of fun. While practicing and trying to understand complicated concepts, we laughed and made jokes and even made a bet over a math question that I lost. Oops. So I had to bring cupcakes to class. And now you're here at graduation, and most of you will never have to think about differential calculus again. So when looking back, don't remember that the math was hard or that we were mainly studying from home amidst the pandemic. Please remember the good things, that you accepted and embraced the challenge, that you showed courage, that you overcame obstacles as a class and became better friends for it. Real life is very similar to math. Mathematics is not a careful march down a well-cleared highway, but a journey into a strange wilderness where the explorers often get lost. But just like in real life, mathematics gives hope that every problem has a solution. Choose to find that solution. Choose to see the good and fun parts of every situation on every step of your journey. You have bright futures ahead of you, and even though you will soon have to do your own laundry, there will also be freedom to explore the world and all the great things that it has to offer. I'm very proud of what you have achieved, and I'm honored to be here today to celebrate that success with you. Dear graduates, I hope that our paths will intersect again. There's no limit to your future. Optimize your path, keep it positive, and make it count.
Thank you, Ms. Kiskin. I really like the puns that you had about optimization and limits. Now let's watch each of our favorite moments of the IBDP. I know that this has been a stressful time for most of us, but when looking back, we each have that one moment that we will always remember throughout our lives. These core moments of our high school experience contribute and shape us into the people that we will become. Let this be a celebration of education. For me, collaboration with the other students in my IB classes made the journey easier and more enjoyable. It was great to work with my fellow students in classes such as math, where we tackled some challenging math problems together, and in chemistry and physics, where we did some group test reflections so that we could perform better in our final exams. I'm glad that I've been able to become more reflective and collaborative throughout high school and looking forward to what's next in life.
Throughout IBDP, I learned that it is very important to always try new things and be open to new experiences and opportunities. Be it joining volleyball, the math club, MUN, an online program based on the line and you're interested in, a competition, because those are the main memories that you will be left with after high school, and from those you will learn and develop your skills. And throughout those experiences, you will find new people that will help you grow and help you along your journey.
My favorite moment from IBDP was being able to work together with my classmates in my CAS projects and higher CAS projects in school.
My favorite thing in IB is that I didn't have to struggle alone after going to group home. I like how we live from deadline to deadlines and have almost no time to spend together. But mainly, I cherish the little moments where we support each other in the darkest times of our life.
In the past 2 years, I've discovered many flaws in my ways. I've received copious amounts of help and support from my teachers to get around the goals or things that I'm very thankful.
During the IB, I learned how to review, compare, and contrast my options to make the best decision for me, for example, for university and for other future endeavors. I will be taking this skill into the future as I think it's very helpful.
During my last 2 years in ACG, I gradually learned a bunch of new things. In art, I learned that to make a drawing, you need to have patience, like you need to be slow and steady. Otherwise, it's going to look messy. So I pretty much learned to, like, you know, have the time to make it artworks.
The one thing I learned during the IB is to be more alert and to be always on standby, because you never know when an assignment is set and when an important management message has been posted. So it is important to always check for notifications and for any new assignments or messages from teachers, since our job as students are to be more responsible and to be more aware of what is going on.
During year 30, I learned to be more conscientious by looking at my school grades and to do better than I was before. From this lesson, it is important to always improve yourself from how you were previously and still keep trying.
My favorite moment at ACG is the esports event that I organized with my friends. I like how everyone was cheering for their friends and house members.
What I've learned in IBDP is that I never give up, like how I managed to keep going and then check carefully in the IBDP exam before submitting it. And my favorite moment in the IBDP is that how his kid set up the party and he was excited.
Yeah.
Every year at ACG School Jakarta, we recognize and applaud the highest academic achievers in the cohort. So now, with some words of wisdom, I am proud to introduce to you this year's salutatorian, Miss Rebecca Balanescu.
Thank you, Mr. Todd. First and foremost, I would like to thank you all for the opportunity to speak on this momentous occasion, and also to thank you for this prestigious academic award. I joined this incredible community in 2020, in the first year of the pandemic. As a third culture kid, I had always struggled with my cultural identity. Throughout high school only, I studied in three different countries, on two different continents, three different schools, and to be honest, I was incredibly nervous to join ACG, especially directly into a virtual environment. I mean, imagine joining your first day of class on Zoom as you feel that everyone is staring and judging you. It can be scary. All my life, while moving from one place to another, having to leave old friends to adapt to new situations, I finally realized that nothing is permanent in my life. And this idea of permanence made me think. Because in fact, nothing is permanent physically, because mentally nothing is gone. When I joined ACG, being terribly nervous, I was encountered with a surprise, an event that shattered my negative expectations, and that was the incredible people in this community. I was completely taken by surprise by all the love and care this community loves to give and keeps giving daily, with Mr. Hutchinson and Mr. Todd encouraging me to challenge myself, from the friends that I made along the way, and the teachers helping me adapt to virtual classes. I'll never forget the lessons that I learned here, both academic and practical, which formed a sense of permanence for me. I thought of my speech today as a journey in my living memories. And this is a rich and wonderful journey, a journey of remembrance. So I'll take you along the way. The places I would like you to visit with me today are numerous and astonishing. They include my journey from being prefect, or perfect, as I like to call it, then head girl alongside Anne and Rahim, from the prefect and the student council peers, from last year's head boy and head girl, Isabel and Danu. Thank you so much, everybody. Only through being a part of the student council could I become more compassionate, caring, and empathetic towards my peers and community. This journey is about wonderful events we organize together, such as Mental Health Awareness Week, ACG's Got Talent, or Literacy Week, just to name a few. It is about extracurricular activities such as MUN Singapore, which taught us to be open-minded and mindful of each culture. Thank you so much, Mr. McTiernan. It is about the Inspired Global Student Leadership Committee, which helped us consider ethics of choices and actions. Thank you so much, Ms. Pickering, and for being part of the assembly team. I would also like to thank Anne and Rahim for always being there and giving me unfiltered advice, telling me when I was wrong and when I should do better. All these memories will never be gone. They will stay permanently with me. I'm deeply honored to be this cohort salutatorian, but this speech will not be about academics. While writing it, I must confess that a certain someone told me to sugarcoat my experience. I'm really sorry, but I will not be doing that today. IB has been very, very difficult. I do not want to scare future IB students, but the IBDP is about difficulties, disappointments, challenges, and work. A whole lot of work. So much work. Sometimes full nights of work. It has taken a toll on our mental well-being, physical health, and sadly, our social life. We as a cohort have had some arguments this year, I must admit. But I'm so glad that we went through all of that together and we learned from our mistakes. And this experience will permanently stay with us. Finally, now, everyone can say goodbye to all the all-nighters we spend cramming for exams, trying to absorb as much information as we can last minute. From all the mental breakdowns the IAs gave us, stresses of CAS, the pain of EE, from all the tears that we've shed rewriting our TOK essay 1 week before the deadline and having to choose completely new examples, as in my case, I'm so sorry, Mr. Todd, or completely redoing our exhibition one night before because one of you snatched two of my objects last minute. I'm still salty about that, by the way. A word of advice for future IB students, take it from me, please don't completely change your entire EE topic after DP1. This tip will save you a lot of unneeded pain. And of course, always choose option C for multiple choice questions as an educated guess. But alas, now, all that is behind us. And we can finally breathe and let all that anxiety go. This feeling of successful completion is permanent. We graduated high school. Not only that, but the impossible diploma program through a global pandemic facing virtual learning for 2 whole years. I think we can all give ourselves a pat on the back. Clearly, IB gave us, not clearly, sadly, IB gave us some academic trauma. But now what? What do we expect now? The hardest question we ask ourselves as students is, what kind of person do I want to be in the future? We as students tend to become overwhelmed by all the possibilities available of everything we can become. But let us take a moment today to acknowledge and appreciate what we are. Mr. Todd taught me about responsibility. Mr. Hutchinson, to be open-minded and caring. Mr. Davis, about time management. Ms. Pickering, about leadership. Mr. McPhee, about growth. Ms. Hiskin taught me about kindness. Ms. Parker taught me to take accountability over my actions. Mr. Swiels about the complexities on human nature. Ms. Datrix about human connections and how fragile they can be. Mr. Agung about compassion. And Madame Dina about joy. All this knowledge we acquired is permanent. It is my honor to thank all faculty, staff, friends, family, and parents that supported us through it all. We regret all the times that we've been difficult and stubborn as a mule. Your efforts did not go unnoticed. We appreciate all the work you've put into us and that help that you gave us along the way. I would also like to thank the teachers that left, Mr. Campbell, Mr. Hickey, and Mr. Winicky, for being incredible teachers to us. We truly miss you. And when many of our high school memories begin to fade, it is those human connections and honest empathy that we'll use to measure the time we spent together. Dear friends, the future can be intimidating. Change your mind and change it again until you're satisfied with the person you have become. So make as many mistakes as you can. That way, when you think about the person you'd want to be in the future, you won't have to guess. When we look back on all our experiences, all our troubles, our sadness, our mistakes, our knowledge, and memories, we will know that they are permanent and they make the persons we have become today. We stand here today on the precipice of the future. It's not a distant reality anymore. It begins here and it begins today. Thank you. Now, it is my greatest honor to welcome this cohort's valedictorian, Rahim Hadi. He works so incredibly hard and genuinely deserves it. Good job.
Thank you for the wonderful salutatory address, Rebecca. I think it was very heartfelt for everyone here. While I'm certainly honored to be receiving the title of the valedictorian of the class of 2022 at ACG School Jakarta, I must say that one of the testaments of this award comes with the thought and process of delivering a speech that would be memorable and resonant among all of the graduates, their families, the teachers, and the school administration to this day, and many years into the future. My name is Rahim Hadi, and I joined ACG School Jakarta, my third and graduating high school, a little more than 3 years ago. In a period that I thought was of high uncertainty, however, I remember that within a year, on March the 3rd, 2020, everything was completely changed for us then students, teachers, and everyone around the world. Some of us even wondered whether that day was our last day together learning in person, and it turns out it was. While these times were arguably the most uncertain during our high school chapter, and we passed through numerous difficulties, whether internal or external, my graduates, I believe that you have several reasons to be proud of your achievements today. From completing the entirety of your senior high school online amidst the pandemic, to persevering and completing the monstrous number of assessments and projects before your deadlines, no matter how many extensions you had to ask for, you've truly demonstrated that you're unhindered and capable of adapting to tentative situations, and have no doubts that you'll be successful in the next stage of your lives. Not only were you there for me when I needed your help, but I'm glad that we were able to work together to get to know each other more, no matter how new to the school some of us were. I would especially like to thank Ewan Komasira right there for working with me as part of the STEM Peer Learning Club to make learning math and the sciences more mutual and more fun and more compassionate together for those that are in the cohort and those that are outside the cohort. Not only does the class of 2022 consist of compassionate tutors, but also team workers and singers, choreographers, artists, programmers, and content creators, as well as humanitarians. Personally, I think you're all valedictorians through your passion and persistent experience of climbing hills and valleys to achieve a better version of yourselves and steadily approaching your own definition of success. I hope that you're all proud of your achievements, and I wish you all happiness and success in your future endeavors. Of course, the persistent efforts and encouragements of our teachers in ensuring our success can't be left out. No matter how many deadlines you bestowed us with, no matter how many hours of sleep we lost as a cause, in the end, it is the teachers who ensured that the learnings that we completed were to the best of our standards and that they supported us whenever we needed. Therefore, I would like to speak for all of our IB teachers who were present at the graduation, as well as those who unfortunately couldn't make it. I would like to thank Mr. Devis for supporting us as our final advisor at ACG School Jakarta, and for making chemistry class fun. Ms. Harrison, for inspiring us to spread knowledge through peer learning and student-led discussions in physics. Ms. Pickering, for teaching us how to solve differential equations outside school hours and encouraging us to delve in practical mathematical investigations. And to Madame Dina, who taught us how to sing our ABCs en français. Mr. Swills, for making English class chill and concise, yet enjoyable and very knowledgeable. And Mr. McTiernan for being our year 11 and year 12 advisor, supporting us throughout our ITGS IR projects till the very last few days, and of course, never giving up on asking the graduates to turn on their cameras during the meetings. I think we know how much we've had that in our advisory lessons. The long list of our thank yous cannot be fit into this address, therefore I would like to extend my gratitude on behalf of the graduates to the other teachers who have supported us and helped us reach culmination over the last 2 years. While independent commitment and support from our teachers definitely play a role for the graduates arriving to this day, I would also like to thank the class of 2022 parents for standing up for their children's education and nourishment over the last 18 years. We dearly thank you for feeding us when we were infants, educating us to be decent as we pass through adolescence, and most of all, preparing us to step out independently to the unknown yet exciting world ahead. I would like to thank my own parents for always being there to comfort me during stressful times, to console me and encourage me to look towards the brighter side during times of disappointment. I really thank you for that. But today, I sincerely hope that all the parents have something to be greatly proud of their graduates. On a closing note, for some of us, today is probably the last day that we will be together celebrating our achievements. 50 years from now, we may forget each other's names, although I hope not, because we were always only a class of 12. As you continue to explore deeper into your passion and make important decisions in your lives, I would encourage you to reflect on your experience during high school and how you can make yourself better in the next stage of your lives. And to the future graduates who might be watching this ceremony online, I would encourage you to reflect on your learnings as we approach the end of another academic year, and how you can also improve yourself in the next year or final year of high school. With that being said, it is an honor to have been given the opportunity to serve as the head boy at ACG School Jakarta. And I really thank everyone for giving me the opportunity to stand before you as a valedictorian of the class of 2022. Thank you for listening. Now, I would like to introduce Nadira Oriola de Winter, who has been chosen to deliver the student choice address for this graduation. Please welcome her on stage.
There is no blue without yellow and without orange. Vincent van Gogh. Believe it or not, about 10 years ago, I was a very quiet kid. Luckily, I had the most lively and expressive teacher who pushed me out of my comfort zone by making me do a bunch of presentations. She taught me how to raise my voice and speak up for myself. A few years after being in her class, ex-students of hers who were still attending the school were asked to pay a visit to her classroom and make a presentation about something we learned while we were her students. And ironically, amongst the presentations my peers made about spelling or how to kick a football effectively, I had prepared a presentation about presenting. I remember this moment so vividly because I can still visualize the blank faces staring back at me with the sound of slow and hesitant claps in the background when I finished speaking. My presentation did not translate the way I wanted it to, and nobody seemed to need what I had said as much as I did at that age. The embarrassment got to me, and I was back at square one. I've never felt that way since I moved to ACG. I was greeted by a community that not only accepted me with open arms, but helped me grow into a person I couldn't have imagined being. In the 5 years that I have been a student here, I've made and developed bonds that I would consider to be unbreakable. It was a matter of finding the right environment to flourish in, and in my time at ACG, the students, teachers, and staff created exactly that. Blue on its own is beautiful, but it will not live up to its full potential and be as vibrant as can be without its complementary colors, yellow and orange. Rachel, Amy, Michelle, and Ario, I want to thank you guys for being the compliments to my blue. Although you're not physically here with me today, I hope you know how important you are to me, because ultimately, you have helped me get through the past 2 years more than you can imagine. I'm still quite mad that I won't get to throw my cap with you guys by my side. Especially Rachel, because we've been fantasizing about that moment since we were 11. But even without your presence on the podium, you're all joined here with me in my heart. Papa, Mama, you are the palette to the painting that I'm creating for myself. I can't thank you enough for every choice and sacrifice you may have made to bring me to this exact moment. And although you may not understand some of my teen antics, you've given me a life full of joy and support so far. Thank you for always choosing me. I couldn't have asked for better parents, and ik hoop dat ik jullie trots kan maken. Graduates, although we're not the most tight-knit class, I've been watching each of you from the sidelines. And I can confidently say that we've all changed a great deal from when we each started at ACG. I'm so glad to be up on the stage with you, and I can't wait to see where life takes you all. And I simply can't say goodbye to the group chat that we made in year 8, so let's not desert it yet and stay connected as a class. To my friends, parents, this graduating class, and everything and everyone in between, I wear the things that I've been taught by you as a badge, and I will bring you all along with me as I start making my own decisions and carve my own path in this world. As hard as it is to accept myself, guys, we're finally growing up. Thank you for listening.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we move towards the awarding of the diplomas, I would like to point out the obvious to you. All of these photographers, professionals with very expensive equipment. So as we're awarding the diplomas, please stay seated. There's no need for you to stand up and come to the front of the stage. Okay, thank you for paying attention. Students, please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the principal, Mr. Sean Hutchinson, and the school registrar, Ms. Mia Sari, for the presentation of the diplomas. So without further ado, graduates, it gives me great pleasure to announce the names of the graduating class of 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Sangon Park. Bryant Rye. Kai Ramadana Widoyo Kogiso. Tristan Ario Sedato. Nadira Aurelia De Winter. Muhammad Rahim Hadi. Satria Rana Wiraputra. Akash Satish Kumar. Woosang William Kim. Ewan Komasuria. Rebecca Maria Balanescu. An Tai Vu Kim. Students, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, parents and colleagues, now gives me great pleasure to introduce Mr. Sean Hutchinson to the stage to give the principal's closing remarks.
Good morning, parents, faculty, staff, and students. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the wonderful support staff, the graduation committee, and the many people involved in coordinating this year's graduation ceremony. For years 12 and 13, the International Baccalaureate Diploma Program is a prestigious international qualification that is recognised by higher education institutions around the world. We are delighted that a number of our Year 13 students have already received acceptances to universities. We are also pleased that some of our students are choosing a gap year to prepare for their next steps beyond secondary schooling. The IB diploma journey would be very challenging for students to face on their own. I sincerely thank the parents for their love, guidance, support, and belief in their children and the school. I would also like to thank all of the IB diploma teachers for their hard work, commitment, and willingness to go the extra mile to assist our students. I would especially like to thank Mr. Richard Todd for his leadership and tireless support for our graduating class and their teachers. As a school, we are obviously hoping that we've played a very small part in shaping who our students have become. We hope that strong family values and our school's core values of excellence, partnerships, integrity, and compassion have been instilled in each and every one of our students. We hope that they will continue to demonstrate these core values and carry the lessons they have learned at ACG with them throughout their future endeavours. For 4 years now, I have been lucky to have observed the unwavering commitment of our graduating class and have watched new students be welcomed in and demonstrate these same qualities. It is difficult to describe this cohort or to try and sum them up as a collective. Some students undoubtedly epitomise hard work, and others may be described as industrious or ambitious. No matter how these students are defined in their own unique individuality, these students have all shown perseverance, resilience, and determination in their way to walk their own path. Now, for the moment you've all been waiting for, graduates, please stand. As a symbolic gesture of their graduation from high school, our graduates will now turn their tassels from right to left. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels. Congratulations to ACG School Jakarta's Class of 2022.
Different in a good way. Together.
Graduates, would you like to go outside on the entrance to take a group photograph? And you can go and get your cap so you can do the cap toss again, please. Parents, keep dancing if you like. Oh, we would need some music though, wouldn't we? If we were dancing to no music.